Hello friends, welcome back to another episode by Engineering Today, and I hope you're all having a great time. SpaceX CEO Elon Musk has announced a slight delay in the seventh test flight of the Starship launch vehicle. Initially planned for January 10th, the test is now expected to take place next week, as shared by Musk during a live stream on his social media platform X. While the reason for the delay was not revealed, SpaceX continues to focus on advancing its groundbreaking technology. The upcoming test is an important step in SpaceX's mission to improve space exploration and satellite deployment. For the first time, Starship will carry 10 Starlink simulators to assess its capability to deploy next-generation satellites. These simulators will follow a suborbital trajectory and are planned to splash down in the Indian Ocean. The test will help SpaceX demonstrate the Starship's ability to handle heavier and more advanced payloads for future missions. These mock Starlink satellites match the size and weight of SpaceX's future third-generation internet beaming satellites. This step will help SpaceX assess Starship's ability to transport payloads to orbit and release them safely. No Starship flight has carried such a payload before, except for a small toy on an earlier test flight. Engineers will also gather valuable data through smaller experiments. For instance, one of Starship's Raptor engines will be reignited in space, and tests on heat-resistant tiles are being conducted. The launch includes trials of new heat tile designs, including one equipped with active cooling technology. The flight test will also include significant upgrades. The upper stage of Starship has reduced and repositioned flaps to lower heat exposure and simplify the design of protective tiles. Propulsion system improvements have increased propellant capacity by 25%, while a backup layer has been added to the heat shield tiles for added protection. The Super Heavy booster, equipped with Raptor engine number 314, will attempt to return to the launch site for a catch using the launch tower's chopstick arms. If conditions don't allow, it will perform a soft splashdown in the Gulf of Mexico. To improve recovery accuracy, SpaceX has upgraded the tower's radar sensors. And for the first time, Starship hardware is being reused, showing significant progress in the company's plans to make space travel more sustainable. Raptor engine number 314, one of the Super Heavy's rocket's 33 Raptor engines, which was previously used during Starship's fifth test flight, will be a key part of this mission. That flight was the only one so far where the booster returned safely, giving SpaceX its first chance to reuse a component. Meanwhile, Elon Musk recently shared his thoughts on colonizing Mars during a conference, and a clip of his remarks has gone viral. Musk humorously commented on how future aliens might view humanity's progress. He said they might look back and think, "They almost made it. Too bad they regulated themselves. They had the rocket and everything." His statement sparked laughter from the audience, highlighting his lighthearted yet thought-provoking approach to discussing space exploration. Musk's comment underscores the importance of pushing boundaries and embracing innovation, especially in ambitious projects like Mars colonization. SpaceX continues to lead in advancing space technology, making significant strides toward achieving interplanetary travel. In other news, SpaceX has made significant progress in reducing the impact of its Starlink satellites on astronomical observations. With over 4,000 Starlink satellites in orbit, accounting for more than half of all satellites around Earth, their presence has raised concerns among astronomers about interference in images. However, SpaceX is actively working to address these issues. One of the key steps SpaceX has taken is lowering the altitude of its satellites. The company recently deployed 400 Starlink V2 mini-satellites at 350 kilometers, compared to the usual 500 to 550 kilometers. This adjustment has shown promising results. A report to the FCC highlighted that these lower-altitude satellites reduce visibility in astronomical images by 60%, according to studies conducted with the Vera Rubin Observatory. At these altitudes, satellites are blocked from sunlight for longer portions of the night, making them appear much fainter. SpaceX is also collaborating with the National Science Foundation to evaluate these changes. The NSF has confirmed that lower altitude not only reduce reflected sunlight, but also help the satellites remain below the visibility limit of the human eye for most of the night. In addition to helping astronomy, the lower altitudes benefit Starlink users by reducing latency and improving internet speeds. SpaceX plans to monitor these outcomes closely as it continues deploying the licensed satellites and seeks approval for more in the future. On the other hand, Jeff Bezos's Blue Origin announced it would launch its first orbital rocket no earlier than Friday, a pivotal moment in the commercial space race currently dominated by Elon Musk's SpaceX. Then the Amazon founder's rocket company delayed the launch on Sunday, the 12th of January, due to rough seas. Named New Glenn, the rocket is slated to lift off from the Cape Canaveral Space Force Station in Florida. In an update posted on the X social media platform, Blue Origin said, "We are shifting our NG-1 launch date to no earlier than January 12th due to a high sea state in the Atlantic where we hope to land our booster. Our 3-hour window remains the same, opening Sunday at 1 a.m. Eastern Standard Time. This launch will carry a simulator of Blue Origin's Blue Ring platform, a system designed to host and deliver payloads to destinations such as geosynchronous orbit, the Moon, and other planets. New Glenn's successful debut would establish Blue Origin as a contender in the orbital payload market, a field currently led by SpaceX's Falcon 9 and Falcon Heavy. It would also support Amazon's Project Kuiper, an internet satellite program set to rival SpaceX's Starlink. Both companies have ambitious goals. New Glenn aims to secure certifications for Department of Defense missions and is slated to support NASA's Mars mission in 2025. Starship continues to refine its design, focusing on achieving full reusability for the Super Heavy booster and the spacecraft itself. On the other hand, Japan's innovative wooden satellite, Lignosat, has entered orbit after being deployed from the International Space Station. This groundbreaking project, developed by Kyoto University in collaboration with the Japan Aerospace Exploration Agency, explores the potential of wood as a sustainable material for spacecraft. Lignosat was delivered to the ISS in November 2024 to test how wood withstands the harsh conditions of space. The primary objectives include studying the wood's durability against cosmic radiation and monitoring how the Earth's geomagnetic field interacts with the satellite. By using wood, researchers aim to find eco-friendly alternatives to traditional spacecraft materials like aluminum. The satellite's structure uses Hinoki magnolia wood, chosen after testing 3 wood types in space. The panels, measuring just 10 centimeters in length, were crafted with a traditional Japanese wood joinery method called the blind miter dovetail joint. This technique avoids the need for glue or nails, making it a unique and efficient design. Lignosat's launch is part of the Japanese Experiment Module Small Satellite Orbital Deployer 30 mission. The satellite will orbit Earth for a few months before re-entering the atmosphere and burning up. This short-term mission could have long-term implications as researchers consider wood for more significant satellite components. Future designs might reduce the use of aluminum even further, potentially paving the way for greener satellite construction. The project comes at a time when satellite launches are becoming increasingly frequent. SpaceX recently deployed 24 Starlink satellites, highlighting the urgent need to explore sustainable materials for space missions. Lignosat's success could inspire similar innovations, aligning space exploration with environmental goals. And that's all for now.
Thanks for watching. Please subscribe for more videos like this. Hit the like button if you find the video interesting. And kindly provide your valuable feedback in the comment section. This will help us to improve.